Welcome back to lesson 3 of the Build a Full App with Swift Data course. In the last lesson, we did a bunch of things, including archiving your app ideas, and we also added this content unavailable view here, which I just wanted to show you as a refresher. So if I rerun it in the simulator, then this is how the app actually looks if we have some app ideas in there. So we just have a list of all the app ideas. We can click on them and edit them as we wish, and then also add features to the app ideas. So pretty nice so far. In this lesson, we will enable the user to mark their app ideas as favorites. We will add a separate section here in our list for the favorite app ideas, and we will also be adopting an app group for SwiftData as a preparation for lesson 4, the next lesson, in which we will add a widget that gets synced, or that gets their SwiftData data store synced from the main app. That widget will also be interactive. All of that is part of lesson 4. This one is a preparation for that because we want to enable the user to toggle the favorite status of app ideas in the widget. That's why we're starting right now in the app idea file, which is our model class. And in here, we will add another flag and we will just call it isFavorite. Will also be a bool, will be false by default. And let's also quickly add that to our initializer. So isFavorite is a bool, false by default, and then self.isFavorite will be isFavorite, just like that. That way, newly created app ideas are non-favorited, and then the user will have to explicitly favorite them. So with our model class updated, let's go back into our content view. This is the list that we have over here. And specifically, we have these app ideas list row. So if we command click on that to open that file, we will see that we have swipe actions here. So on the leading or on the trailing side, sorry, we can swipe to delete or to archive an app idea. So next we want to also add another swipe action on the leading side to favorite your app ideas. So let's specify the edge and allows full swipe in here. So we want this swipe action to be trailing, and we don't want it to allow a full swipe, because that way users can't accidentally full swipe to delete their app ideas. And then additionally, we will add another swipe action here for the leading edge, which does allow full swipe, because favoriting an idea is not a destructive action. So I think it is totally fine to allow the full swipe here. And I also always prefer the trailing closure syntax, which is why I refactored that a bit. And then in here, we can just add a button with a label just as before. As the label, we will say favorite. And then this system image here should be a star. It should be non-filled if the app idea is not favorite yet, and it should be filled if the app idea is favorite. So we will say if idea.isFavorite, then we want star.fill. Otherwise, we just want star. And then for the button logic, let's just say isFavorite.toggle. And now we can run that in a simulator and have a look at it right away. So we still have our trailing archiving action, and now we have our leading action over here, but I really dislike this being gray. So instead of gray, let's give this entire button a tint of perhaps yellow. I think that should fit with the favorite theme. And now we can see we have a star here, but actually it gets automatically filled by the system. So I think that that our logic here doesn't really make sense. So instead we should say star dot slash. Let me quickly have a look at how that is exactly used. So star dot slash, okay, without the ed. So now if the app is not favorite yet, then we will have a star. And if it is favorite, or is a favorite app idea, then we have a star dot slash symbolizing that we are removing the favorite status. So that's pretty good for now as well. And I think we are done with our app ideas list row as well. So let's go back to the content view where we have this actual list. And let's make sure that we show a separate section for our favorite app ideas. So in our list, let's get rid of this thing over here and let's quickly just copy our list row and we will add two sections. We will add one called favorites and this is to be done. And then we will add another called all. And of course in here, we will then need a for each of our app ideas. I think it's just called ideas, yeah. And then in here, we will have our app ideas list row. But we actually now need a separate computed variable to decide which ideas are favorite and which aren't favorited. Because right now, favorite ideas would be in both sections, the first one and the second one. So let's now create two computed properties here to make sure that an app idea is only ever shown in one of these two sections. So I will call this var favorite ideas. And this will be an array of app idea. And this will just be ideas.filter. And we want the filter to be the is favorite flag. So only the ideas that are favorite will be part of this array. And then we can just copy paste that. And let's call this one non-favorite ideas. And you could just add the exclamation mark here, or I prefer this syntax because the exclamation mark is often overlooked in the beginning, which might confuse you in the end, which is why I just personally preferred using the syntax as it's just a bit easier to understand. So now in our all section, we can use the non-favorite ideas instead. And then we can just copy that exactly for our favorites and use the favorite ideas. So now if we give that a run, we will notice that we have two sections. The first one is obviously empty. So let's swipe over our workout tracker, tap on that, and there you can see it is automatically moved to the favorite section, which is really nice. All right, so I want to add two more things. First of all, the app group, but we will do that last. Before that, let's go back to our list row because in here we already have the sensory feedback when an idea is archived, but let's also add a sensory feedback of perhaps increase when the idea is favorite changes. And this way the user will get some haptic feedback when they're swiping over their apps to be favorite or non-favorite. All right, so that's already all the code. Let's now jump into our project file and in our app target, we will go to the signing and capabilities tab and we will select a new capability and that one will be app groups. So let's double click that. And then in here, we can create a new app group or I will just use a container that I already created when testing this out. So make sure you just select that container. All right, and that is already all the app group setup we have to do. Now in the next lesson, we will have a look at creating the widget and then we will also make that interactive reading from our Swift data store.